We'll run into all kinds of problems in this country. The whole development paradigm, in my opinion, is not the right development paradigm, because we don't have the three resources that you need for development: land, water and energy. We are deficient in all of those.
Fossil fuel economy, of course, is growing heavily in India.
There is a very strong correlation between mining and poverty in this country, especially with respect to coal mines. There is also a very strong correlation between mining districts of this country and where the naxalism is. Okay, so you have mining, you have poverty, and you have naxalism.
We've just ridden 1800 kilometers on our cycle from Kolkata to Delhi with our case Buy New Coal. What we're essentially doing is questioning our dangerous over-reliance on fossil fuel and highlight alternatives.
This is the Integrated Energy Policy of Planning Commission, where it says that power demand is likely to go up like this. And this is billion kilowatt hours. We are approximately here. And in the forced nuclear and forced hydro scenario, in which it says that they will get maximum hydro possible, maximum nuclear possible, we'll be able to meet only this much demand. All the increase will be taken up by coal.
Where is that coal available? There are projections made in the Integrated Energy Policy document. Some other projections have also made that we have about 40 years of reserves available.
The issue is not whether we will have coal or not. The issue is whether we should be mining coal or not.
Here one seam, underground seam, had been worked. The method of working, you know, they make galleries and they take out coal. So those galleries had already been made, and then they did this open cast. When coal had access to free oxygen, those galleries caught fire.
The background costs for coal, or the hidden costs within coal, are not really talked about.
That's when the concept of externalities comes in. An externality is nothing but the cost that society is paying to generate something. And when we look at the externalities that arise from coal, they're immense. There is a cost for agriculture, water, land, forests, health.
But the moment you build externality cost into power generation through coal, then it will be much more expensive than any other energy forms that are available today.
If you consider the coal-based electricity, after, you know, you consider all the social issues, particularly the environmental issues, the CO2 emission issue, the cost of electricity becomes about 7 to 8 rupees per kilowatt hour.
So the question really needs to be asked is, who is benefiting from this form of electricity generation, and who are the people who are to bear the social and environmental cost? And this is something that has never really been done in good conscience.
And when we start seeing them in detail, burning coal just does not make sense. At times when there is a climate emergency, where there is a water and a food crisis,
climate change is already in your rear view window. You know, it's no longer in the front view window. It's already happened.
And there are predictions again from scientists in the last few days saying they think that the Arctic will be free of sea ice within the next 4 to 5 years. So this is very dramatic news that must make us think again about how urgent is the action to really start to reduce greenhouse gas emissions around the world.
The impact of that can be huge in terms of sea level rise, in terms of disruption in climate systems. It's so huge that that we cannot even think through what the impact could be.
But India is not, while it is one of the largest greenhouse gas emitters in the world, in the global scheme of things, we are actually quite small. We're large because we are a large country, we're a lot of people, and we have a significant, because of that, we have a reasonably large economy. But we actually are a poor country.
We are living behind a dark world. This is criminal.
So all you are extracting this coal for the benefit of humanity. And if you're going to destroy humanity, then what is the idea of getting this coal?
Do we have an alternative? Do we have a cost-effective alternative? Do we have an immediate alternative?
It's going to be very difficult for India, in fact, pretty much impossible for India, to move away from coal in any significant fashion. Regardless of how much we'd like to do that, I think in the next 10 or 20 years, it's going to be almost impossible.
If you start investing in renewable energy now, in 20 years' time, it will become competitive to coal.
We can generate full energy, full power, what we need in India from the renewable.
But energy conservation will actually fetch you far more minerals than any of these renewables today are going to fetch you.
I want now electric buses, I want electric cars, I want to change all this CO2 nonsense.
If you use the same money to do energy efficiency, you'll be getting many times more.
The so-called carbon capture and storage, CCS, that has become the darling concept of the Western world, is a very stupid concept.
Enthusiasts for nuclear tend to say that nuclear is clean, and by no means is it clean. It's one of the dirtiest technologies.
I suspect we'll have to start looking at something very different. Which is, within that large context, how much energy do we really need and for what?
In the midst of the multiple crises the world is going through and India is going through, you have the climate chaos, you have the financial breakdown, you have the food crisis, and of course the energy crisis of fossil fuels running out. The solution to all of them is localized biodiversity economies that create another decentralized network of using less to get higher welfare.
It is going to be large gatherings of people who will eventually do this.
I think it's possible. It's a willpower issue.
We've been talking to a lot of experts, we've been talking to a lot of people, and I've faced a lot of skepticism. They're absolutely right in being skeptical about the future, because the solutions are within us. We don't have to seek outside for them. We don't have to wait for some breakthrough to happen for life to change. It's really that switch is inside us which can make sure that life starts changing. And I think it's going to come soon.